I'm going to show you how to get more views for your YouTube videos by posting an animated GIF to your YouTube community tab. And we're going to create that animated GIF using Apple Keynote, the free presentation software that comes with every Mac. Now, before we jump in, if you're not familiar with the YouTube community tab, it's like a social media feed for your YouTube channel, where you can post different types of content for your subscribers. But here's what makes the community tab such a powerful tool for growing your YouTube channel. You see, the content that you post to your community tab is not only shown to your current subscribers, it's also shown to new non-subscribers on YouTube, which means with the community tab, you have the potential to reach and attract a brand new audience, get more views and subscribers, growing your YouTube channel. Now, you can create different types of posts on your community tab: text posts, image posts, polls. You can even post clickable thumbnails for your YouTube videos. But one of the most versatile and engaging forms of content you can post to your community tab is an animated GIF. I know, just what the world needs, more animated GIFs. But in the context of the YouTube community tab, an animated GIF is the next best thing to posting an actual video to your community tab, which you cannot do right now, at least not at the time of this recording. But why would I want to actually post an animated GIF to my YouTube community tab anyway? Well, one of the most effective uses is as a preview or teaser for one of your YouTube videos. Now, you can already promote a YouTube video by posting a clickable thumbnail known as a video link post. But according to several big YouTubers and YouTube channel managers, video link posts get the least amount of engagement. An animated GIF, on the other hand, has one big advantage over other types of community posts: it moves, so it's more likely to catch a user's attention. It's also customizable. Along with grabbing a few frames from a video, depending on the software that you use, you can also add text and other graphic elements to an animated GIF. Now, you can create an animated GIF from a video using a number of different apps and services, but what I'm going to show you right now is a quick and easy way to create an animated GIF from a video using Apple Keynote. Let's jump in. So here we are in Keynote. Now, right off the bat, you need Keynote version 9.2 or above to be able to create animated GIFs. All right, I have a blank project here. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is change the aspect ratio of my document from the 16:9 to 1:1, which is square. The square aspect ratio works better in the YouTube community tab feed, especially on mobile. So I'll change the document aspect by selecting the document button, then down under slide size, selecting custom slide size. Then in the dialog, entering in 1080 by 1080. And that gives me a square slide. Next, I'm going to drag in one of my YouTube videos and place it on the slide. I'm going to take a section of this video and turn it into an animated GIF, which I'll post to my community tab to promote the full video. Now, important thing to keep in mind, the YouTube community tab has a file size limit for images, including GIFs, which is 16 megabytes. So with that in mind, I'm going to keep my animated GIF short, around 8 seconds. So I'm going to select an 8-second clip from my YouTube video using Keynote's trim function. So I'll select the video on the slide, then I'll go up and select the format button, then select movie, then go down and under edit movie, trim, I'll click and drag on these trim handles to select an in and out point for the 8-second clip I want to extract from this video. I'll play back my selected clip by hitting the play button. Next, I'm going to add a caption to my animated GIF by going up to Keynote's top toolbar and selecting the text tool. Then fill in and position the text for the caption. Now, you could animate this text on screen, but I'm just going to leave it static. All right, now I'm ready to export this slide as an animated GIF. And to do that, I'll go up to Keynote's top menu and select File, Export to, Animated GIF. I'll leave slides set to 1:1 because I only have one slide. These next two settings are important. Remember, there is a file size limit for images posted to the YouTube Community tab, including animated GIFs, and that limit is 16 megabytes. These two settings, resolution and frame rate, will help us keep our animated GIF within that 16 megabyte limit. Keep an eye on the resolution output down here. Right now it's set to 1080 by 1080. Now I know from experimenting that 1080 by 1080 resolution is going to be too big. The file size is going to be too large. So I'm going to change the resolution setting from extra large to large, which reduces the resolution to 720 by 720 pixels, as you can see down here. Now you could reduce the file size more by selecting medium, which reduces the resolution to 480 by 480 pixels. I'll keep mine set to large at 720 by 720. But I will reduce the frame rate from 24 frames per second to 15 frames per second to reduce the number of frames in my animated GIF, which will reduce the file size. Now, unfortunately, Keynote doesn't have precise resolution or quality controls for making animated GIFs. So if you're making animated GIFs for the YouTube Community tab, you'll have to experiment a little bit by exporting your animated GIF, then checking the file size in the macOS Finder. All right, back over in Keynote, I'll make sure Auto Advance is set to 0 seconds so that there's no delay when the animated GIF starts looping. I'll make sure Export with Transparent Backgrounds is unchecked. My animated GIF doesn't have any transparent areas. I'll hit Next, then find a place to save my animated GIF, then hit Export. Then I'll go find my animated GIF in the Finder and select it. And you can see in the info section that the animated GIF I created is under the 16 megabyte limit for the YouTube Community tab. Nice. All right, over on the Community tab for my YouTube channel, I'm going to create a new image post. I'll enter some text. I'll create a link to the full YouTube video. Then I'm just going to drag and drop the animated GIF I exported out of Keynote onto this upload area. And there's a preview of my animated GIF. And the fact that I'm seeing the preview tells me that the file size is under the 16 megabyte limit and everything is good. I'll hit Post to post the animated GIF to my YouTube Community tab. And there's my post. An eye-catching little preview of the full YouTube video.
A great way to attract new users to your channel and get more views for your videos. And if you're looking for more ways to use Apple Keynote to create engaging YouTube content, have a look at this playlist on my channel.